talking about that little girl that got murdered?
You got something to tell us?
I know shit from Shinola.
The Twin Peaks film, like the TV show, opens with a question. Who killed Teresa Banks?
Agent Desmond, do you think we should question him?
Because we already know the answer, the question seems perverse. But our protagonists don't know. And as they stumble through their investigation, we realize that we can't rely on their authority. We also realize that we don't know why Teresa was killed, and that this is the more important question.
But I can't tell you about that.
The opening half hour of Fire Walk With Me
can't.
Plays like a parody of the Twin Peaks pilot.
No, I can't.
But with a purpose. To hammer home this point, Chet Desmond replaces
Good
Dale Cooper
you,
as the lead investigator.
Chet, give Sam Stanley the glad hand.
Aloof, reticent, and kind of a dick.
What time is it, Stanley?
Chet is as much the anti-Cooper as Deer Meadow is the anti-Twin Peaks, and Teresa Banks is the anti-Laura Palmer.
No one came to claim the body. No known next of kin.
I figure this whole office, furniture included, is worth $27,000.
Sam Stanley, meanwhile, spoofs Cooper's brilliant powers of observation.
Nicotine's a drug.
By suggesting they are essentially pointless.
Who's the towhead? Those drugs are legal.
When a somber, perplexed Agent Cooper finally appears in the film himself, even he cannot restore our confidence in the FBI.
It's 10:10 a.m.
John Thorne, enwrapped in plastic, concludes that the entire first act of Fire Walk With Me is Cooper's dream.
I was worried about today because of the dream I told you about.
Beginning with Teresa's body floating downstream, and ending when we cut to Twin Peaks 1 year later. According to this theory, Cooper actually conducted the Deer Meadow investigation himself. In sleep, he seeks a more objective perspective.
We sure do need a good wake-me-up, don't we, Agent Desmond?
By imagining Chet Desmond in his place.
We sure do need a good wake-me-up, don't we, Agent Desmond?
Yeah, we do, Sam.
Much as later Lynch characters will project themselves into new personas. After reliving the Teresa Banks case,
Gordon!
Cooper himself appears in his own dream.
Gordon!
To receive visions and cryptic clues from the Lodge.
Who do you think this is there?
Just as he did on the show.
And what's dream? We live inside a dream.
This theory acknowledges David Lynch's original intention for Cooper.
But where did he go?
Who was supposed to be a more active presence in Fire Walk With Me before Kyle MacLachlan decreased his involvement. It also addresses our own desire for Cooper to play a central role in the film.
I'm having a bad dream anyway.
Thorne points out that if this is Cooper's dream, it reflects the structure of Laura's dream later in the movie. Both dreams would begin with an omniscient viewpoint, followed by the dreamer's own appearance within the dream, a visitation by a time-traveling character with a message, and the impossible reflection of these characters within a framed image, positioning them in two places at once. This reading prepares Cooper for his central, heroic, and visionary role in the series. Well, perhaps.
Lately I've been filled with the knowledge that the killer will strike again.
But Fire Walk With Me is not only a prequel to Twin Peaks. It is also a follow-up. And its portrait of Cooper is shaped by his fall. Separating from Mark Frost and resetting the clock, Lynch had the opportunity to restore Cooper's early prowess. Instead, Cooper remains as confused, shaken, and powerless as he was through much of Season 2.
Well, damn, Cooper, that really narrows it down. You're talking about half the high school girls in America.
Cynical Albert Rosenfield.
Get me Agent Chester Desmond out in Fargo, North Dakota.
And kooky Gordon Cole are the same as ever. But the impenetrability of their surrounding world mocks their former proficiency. Even Philip Jeffries, who can break through the surface reality, is rendered incoherent by his experiences.
He's gone!
Physical clues pose more questions than they answer.
Good luck, Chet!
One thing has been troubling me.
And if the blue rose represents the impossibility of knowledge,
I wonder where her ring is.
Teresa Banks' ring,
she's got the ring on,
presents its possibility just out of reach.
We got a phone here. It's got a little ring.
Chet Desmond disappears when he touches this ring, right?
And news from Deer Meadow. Agent Chester Desmond has disappeared.
In fact, we never see him disappear, nor do we see him touch it. His fingers hover around its edges while the film itself freezes and fades. This is the perfect image to convey the FBI's frustrated investigation. Throughout Fire Walk With Me, Lynch will play visual games with Teresa's ring.
Teresa Banks, you look just like my Laura.
When we meet her in flashbacks, the ring is almost always hidden from view. The hand that wears it is crushed under Leland's body.
What are you doing?
Masked by an ice tray, or positioned just barely out of frame. Once Teresa discovers Leland's link to Laura, we finally see the ring on her finger. And when she is killed, she is not wearing it. This ring accompanies her insight into, and power over, Leland, and with him, Bob.
The ring's missing.
This is not the first time a ring links detective to victim.
Give me your ring. I will return it to you when you find these things to be true.
I need to unlock that. I need the answer is inside of me.
Appetite. Satisfaction. A golden circle.
Golden circle. A ring. My ring. I gave my ring to the giant.
Returned only when he is able to hear Lara's voice in his dream.
My father killed me.
But we will never see the ring on his finger again. Not even in Firewalk with Me, which takes place before the first season. Cooper's published autobiography reveals that his mother gave him this ring in a dream, after she was killed by a Bob-like spirit. The boy initially resisted this gift and never understood it. The brilliant detective has always been limited in his comprehension of trauma, which leads in part to his collapse in the series finale.
He's chosen my husband.
Throughout the show, the ring on or off his own finger has always indicated how close he was to the core of Laura's mystery. With this in mind, Cooper's advice to Laura is the final confirmation that the FBI agent does not know what he is talking about.
Don't take the ring, Laura. Don't take the ring.